The U.S. Air Force's McKinley Climatic Laboratory at Elgin Air Force Base in Florida is one of those places that has literally seen it all, including an explosion last month reportedly caused by highly pressurized refrigerants used for cold weather simulations. In total, the lab boasts 6 testing chambers that can simulate conditions from negative 80 to 170 degrees Fahrenheit, rainfall as great as 15 inches an hour, winds as high as 70 miles an hour, and elevations as great as 80,000 feet. These chambers can also simulate ice, snow, and sandstorms, transitioning from a variety of conditions in a matter of hours. Part of the 96th Test Wing, the 55,000 square foot lab, is used by the Air Force, other US and foreign agencies, as well as private companies like Google, Ford, Airbus, and others. One of the more recent inhabitants of the chambers has been the highly touted F-35 fighter jet, which recently took part in some extreme engine testing. Boeing has also done work on its 787 Dreamliner at the facility. However, its inhabitants are not exclusive to those that fly. An equipment testing chamber can be used for tanks, cars, and other equipment. Ford, for example, recently used the facility to test its trucks in extreme winter conditions. Also, different aircraft operations can be performed there, like running the aircraft under extreme thermal loads to test environmental control systems and cooling capacities. The facility was built in 1947 as part of an initiative to take testing out of the natural elements and into an environment that could be manipulated to simulate more extreme conditions. The facility is named after the person who proposed building it, Colonel Ashley McKinley. As you can imagine, the building is engineered in as extreme a manner as the tests it conducts. This includes a floor composed of 25 foot wide, 12 inch thick cement slabs, walls and doors insulated with 13 inches of glass wool board, sheathed in galvanized steel, and foam rubber sealed doors. The ceiling is insulated on a corrugated steel deck suspended from the roof trusses by chains. Even more extreme, operational costs of the facility. It reportedly generates an electric bill of close to $200,000 a month. To help offset those costs, companies wishing to use the facility pay anywhere between $10,000 and $25,000 a day. I'm Jeff Ranke, and this is IAN Now.